Good evening and good to have you with us in this edition of the Urban Debate. Viewers, tonight once again we put the spotlight on the violence that unfolded on the streets of Bengaluru on Tuesday night. Now, on August 11th, it was horror. A mob that ran amok through the night, starting in the evening, killing three people, injuring several others, a large number of policemen including. They targeted a Congress MLA's house. They targeted two police stations. They set vehicles ablaze, vandalized, and then clashed with the police that was trying to bring this mob under control. Why did all of this happen? Because they were apparently upset about a post that had been put up on social media by a relative of this Congress MLA. A post that they claimed hurt their religious sentiments. And they got so angry that they wanted the police to hand over the man who put up this post to them, to the angry mob. When that didn't happen, they absolutely ran amok on the streets. People had to run, hide, journalists were not spared, they were thrashed. Now, we spoke about it 2 days ago, but I want to talk about it again. Because it is important to not just report when such an incident occurs. It is important to continue to track it until we reach the bottom of this story and find out how did this take place? Was it planned earlier? Was it pre-planned? Were there certain elements that incited this mob? Who led them and for what purpose? Now, as the investigation progresses, tough questions have been asked of the Bengaluru police. The Bengaluru police commissioner told us that they are already stretched and understaffed. Many of the policemen in Bengaluru have tested positive for COVID and are not on duty. Others have been quarantined. There are extra shifts that they're running, which is understandable. Almost all of the police forces in our country right now in every city are going through it. But could this also be an intelligence failure if it was a pre-planned conspiracy? How could the mob take over for so many hours in the police struggle? The other important angle and the interesting aspect that has now come forward is the link to political outfits. Multiple people who've been arrested are with the SDPI. There are now people who are arrested who are linked to the Congress party. Let me tell you about four such suspects that are on top of the police's radar and key to their investigation. Muzammil Pasha, he was arrested on August 12th. He is with the Social Democratic Party of India. He's their leader, one of their leaders. He was reportedly the first one to reach the DJ Hali police station. SDPI claims he went there to file a police complaint. What unfolded, what's visible in the video and audible in that video is a completely different story. He addressed the mob present at the police station and the mob that later got so angry and out of control that they resorted to violence. Number two, Feroz Pasha, former Youth Congress president of Hebal constituency, a social worker allegedly supporting the SDPI, was also arrested on August 13. Number three, Kaleem Pasha, arrested on August 13, husband of Congress corporator Irshad Begum, a close aide allegedly of Congress leader KJ George. Police says his supporters were part of the group. Number four, Saeed Ayaz, affiliated with the SDPI, arrested also on August 12th. He was present again at the DJ Hali police station. He too addressed the mob. So, with SDPI and Kong name emerging repeatedly, is this a political conspiracy? If we are being told it was pre-planned, who planned it? That's the question I want to ask. Let's say good evening to the panelists who are joining us right now. Vivek Reddy, spokesperson for BJP Karnataka. Rajesh Kalappa, spokesperson for the Karnataka Congress Party. Manu Ayyappa, chief of political bureau for Times of India in Bengaluru. T.R. Prasad Gowda of the JDS and Dr. Tasleem Ahmed Rehmani, National Secretary of the SDPI. Let me actually first go across to Brijesh Kalappa. Mr. Kalappa, the fact that those who've been arrested are being linked to your own party is a little concerning, especially when the target was your own party MLA.
You see, first, I'd like to say that these arrests have been made today, and that is particularly after the Congress Party has put a lot of pressure on the BJP government for not having acted against, this gentleman called Naveen, despite the fact that the post came up on Sunday. Till Tuesday, the police had not acted. So clearly, there was a mismatch between the police action and the kind of gravity of the offense. So naturally, people are agitated. So we have been consistently putting a lot of pressure, exerting a lot of pressure on the government. So it's obvious that as a hit back, as a counter blast, the government has today arrested the corporator's husband. And what role is ascribed to him is yet to be known. And what he has actually done, what was his role, is still unknown to all of us. And in any case, the point is, the idea is to taint the Congress Party. And that appears at prima facie view. I don't say that, he's absolutely innocent. I've not investigated the matter. I don't know what the facts of the case are. But prima facie, it appears that they are trying to taint the Congress Party. And let them, there's no problem. Because as far as taint is concerned, if Pragya Thakur, who was alleged to have committed serious, who is involved in organizing blasts, which killed several people. So if she has become an MP of the BJP, then I don't think it's possible to say that merely because you're arrested, straight away you've been condemned as guilty.
I think if we go down that road, Mr. Brijesh Kalappa, there will be far too many examples to be quoted from both sides. So let's not go down that road. My simple question to you is, your opening remarks are about action against Naveen. Why is the Congress Party not more interested in action against those mob people? Those who vandalized, those who attacked men in uniform, those who threatened your MLA, wanted to burn his house down, who entered people's homes, allegedly stole stuff. Isn't the Congress Party more concerned about that than one person who put up a social media post?
Tanvi, we are talking, I think on today's Friday, we've been doing this debate since Tuesday, and every single debate, we start by saying that we are totally against the agitators, and the strictest possible action should be initiated against the agitators. Nobody holds a brief for them. If you take the law into your own hands, certainly you need to be punished for it, and most severely.
But those who are the agitators,
if you're asking me 3 days later, why you're not speaking of the agitators, every single leader of ours has spoken about the agitators. Every single leader, whether it's Mr. Siddaramaiah, whether
it's Mr. The agitators are now linked to your party.
No. See, linking, like I said, the arrests have been done today. And when have the arrests been done? After we raised very uncomfortable questions of the government. So obviously the BJP will try to target the Congress Party. And that's the reason I use the word taint us. They will try to taint us.
Okay, Vivek Reddy, please respond to that. Are you arresting these people simply because they're linked to the Congress Party and not because they were responsible for what happened that night?
Tanvi, the age-old and legendary double takes of Congress on these issues is exposed again today. The seriousness of the situation is not understood by them. An incident of this gravity, of this extreme perverted nature, should never have happened. From both sides, whether it is Naveen or whether it is any other person, whether it is the mob. But after it has happened, we find the Congress has a very split approach. One, it starts blaming Naveen. Of course, he is to be blamed. But it only puts across half-hearted blame against the other offender. And this is where we see the legendary hypocrisy of the Congress. And all this is done only for purpose of gains. Now, what I would expect Mr. Brijesh Kalappa to say is, or to understand is, irrespective of who the person is, to which political affiliation he is, if anybody is in the planning of this mob attack, or is involved in this mob attack, he must be arrested, irrespective of the political party. And whereas this story emerged from, it has emerged from Naveen, a Congress activist. Now it has several Congress people on the other side. So irrespective, I would say, please, even if your activists are involved, take a stand and say the party is not involved. Don't ever say that, look here, they're trying to taint the Congress. The police is trying to get at the bottom of it. Is there no respect for truth in this country when such incidents occur? What is the future of this country if you go on painting everything as a political issue? I think this is where they don't understand the seriousness at all. They have done this for years and they will continue to do it. But the issue is today, the police is going to get at the bottom of the story, and whoever is involved will be brought to book. An inquiry is also ordered to find out if there is anything left out in this piece of evidence, whether it is evidence or whatever. And we will get to the bottom of it. The government will also be initiating the law in order to seize the properties of these offenders, and they will be brought to book, no doubt about it.
Okay, let's Brijesh wants to respond to it before I go across to our other panelists. Yes.
Tanvi, first of all, the issue is not regarding the Congress party, right? If a person, let's assume for a moment that this Kaleem or the other person, whomever you mentioned, were actually Congress activists, there's no way in which you can link the Congress party to it, because from day one, the BJP government has been speaking of the SDPI influence, right? And it's also well known that whenever there is a communal conflagration, it's either the BJP which benefits or the SDPI which benefits. It's also our case, and we've been stating it repeatedly, that the BJP has been making noises against the PFI and the SDPI for not now, not just in this incident, for the last 6 years. Now, will you kindly ask Mr. Vivek Reddy why the SDPI or the PFI doesn't stand banned in this country? For the last 6 years, has Mr. Modi remained as the Prime Minister? And why has the PFI, repeatedly they are speaking of the PFI activity, they are saying that PFI killed RSS workers, PFI did this, did that. Why is the PFI still not banned in this country?
Okay.
Can I just come in? 1 minute, Tanvi.
Yes, I will come to that.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Okay, go ahead. Why aren't you banning it? Because this is a question even I have. Repeatedly, you keep telling us PFI is bad, SDPI is bad. They're linked to this riot, that riot, this attack, that attack. Why aren't you banning them? Yes.
No. This recommendation, the Congress never sent a recommendation to ban the
BJP. Why should we make a recommendation, sir?
It is the BJP. Hold on.
Why should we make a recommendation, sir?
Didn't I listen to you?
You're the ones speaking of a ban. So implement the ban.
Didn't I listen to you?
Do it today.
Didn't I listen to you, Brijesh? Hold on. Listen to me. Let me explain your stand. Please have the patience to listen to me. During your regime in 2015, please remember, these memories never fade. 175 cases against PFI and SDPI
were
withdrawn by the
Congress
government.
Were withdrawn
by the Congress government. 1,600 activists facing criminal charges were freed by you. Who is the accused behind these accused of SDPI today? It is your policy of removing them from the cases, withdrawing them from the cases, which has put society to danger today. Don't you understand that? Don't you have some sort
of... No, but you're not answering the question. Who is in power? Yes. Who's in power in Karnataka, Mr. Vivek Reddy? Who's in power in the center? So why isn't this done already? Why isn't it done already? Recommendations don't count if your own party members at the center are not listening to you.
We have come into power now. Till now, the Congress and JDS and the Congress were in power.
Is Mr. Modi come
they
to power now?
That was a long time ago.
They
acquitted them, removed cases from them. This is the hypocrisy of the Congress.
That was a long time ago. You took power for them a long time ago.
We came in 2019.
Okay, let me bring in Mr. Prasad Gowda. Because this is a big allegation, Mr. Prasad Gowda. That the Congress and the JDS government... Let me bring in... We have three other panelists, Mr. Kalappa and Vivek Reddy. I will come back to both of you. Mr. Prasad Gowda should respond this. I want to know why...
Yes. Yes, madam. Madam, our BJP friend
Vivek Reddy... Mr. Prasad Gowda, Mr. Brijesh Kalappa, let Prasad Gowda respond to this.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Our friend, our BJP friend Vivek Reddy is in the mood of, you know, opposition, still in the mood of opposition. In Karnataka, BJP has come to power 1 year back itself. See, the issue here in DJLE and KJLE, I wanted to ask my BJP friends. BJP has seen failures in handling all the issues, including flood, including COVID-19, now the law and order in the state. See, government, who is handling, you have asked a very valid question, Tanvi Shukla, to BJP, my friend, that who is running the government? BJP is running the government here in Karnataka, in the state, as well as in the center also. And it is an utter failure of law and order in the country, in the state, and also intelligence. Who is handling the intelligence? Home Department. See, what's happening today, tomorrow, day after, that should be Home Department has got a wing, intelligence wing. They should be knowing all these criminals, whoever it is. And the tall, we never defend all these criminals or whoever done this. And we are not, never defended all these criminals. And whatever is going to happen, that should have come to the minds of the
No, but is it
department.
True or not, Mr.
They
Gowda?
Handle it properly. Well, see, one second.
Mr. Gowda, respond
one second.
To
madam,
what Vivek Reddy is
please
saying.
Listen to me.
Did you withdraw cases and free
hour,
SDPI
madam, I will,
accused?
Let me complete. Madam, Let me complete. I will listen to them, whatever they say. I will complete my one sentence. See, before the residence of Akhanda Srinivas Murthy, there was a protest happening by the Muslim youths. 1 hour before, by 6:30 they started, up to 7:30 they have protested. And the vibration of the protest, anybody could have recognized that it will go to the some bad extent. So, where were the police people at that time? No police people were seen, and they started burning the legislator's house. And still, they are just spectators. Police are spectators. And DCP was calling Jameer Ahmed and Rijwan Arshad, please come and talk to your people. What is this? Instead of calling the police force, he is calling the, he could have done the, performed the his police duty rather than he is calling the political people. See, and by that time, ruckus has happened and whole city burnt. Now they are telling all good things, BJP people are telling, instead of handling law and order properly and intelligence with them, they are not accepting their fault first. Administration has gone down. Law and order gone down. Intelligence zero. What my dear friend Vivek Reddy, you can
Mr. Prasad Gowda, during
you
Kumar
are,
Swami
you are talking
time,
like an opposition person.
You did nothing during Kumar Swami's time.
Brother, you
please
talk about
me.
Today.
Please
yesterday
me.
They have burnt whole city.
This is the second public
Pulikeshin Nagar, whole that ward, everything is burnt like anything. You forget about Kumar Swami. Talk about
gentlemen,
yesterday
gentlemen,
what happened.
I will not be able to understand anybody if all of you start talking at the same time. Now, this is a very serious issue. Three people have been killed. It was a horrifying experience for even the journalists who were there covering it because even they were not spared. I want to know why is it that people who are linked
point,
to the SDPI and the Congress party are actually those who've been accused and arrested in this case? What is going on? I mean, to what extent are we going to take our politics where we don't think twice before inciting people on ground, leading a mob and resorting to violence, and then we want to turn around and question the BJP on it, Mr. Gowda? The fact of the matter is, why are you asking questions to the Congress and the SDPI today? Their people have been named and arrested in this case. Should you not be asking them as well what's going on?
They are friendly with them. They want their
vote. Of course. See, here... Yeah.
That is why they are afraid.
No. We have nothing to do with any criminals. See, the people who are there before to do such things, we never consider them as any party persons or any associate people. They are all criminals, illegal people. They should be punished like anything. We never be friendly with anybody. we are the last people to support such elements of the society. Yeah, we will call them. Is a bad okay. element should be removed.
Let me ask bad Dr. Tasleem Rehmani this question. Dr. Rehmani, you were on my show people. 2 days ago. At that point of time, you kept denying the involvement of your two people who were there at the police station that you claimed were there to file a police complaint, even though the video and the audio shows a different story about how they were inciting the mob there. Now, 19 people who've been named in the FIR, booked by the Bengaluru police, belong to your outfit. What's going on?
You see, Tanvi ji, the day before also I said that we are not involved in any manner in this case. And today the turn of event has proved my point again that it was a politically motivated happening right from posting on the Facebook page to this unfortunate violence. It's all masterminded by the group that must have to be investigated very clearly and very openly and impartially. Today, the BJP is trying to show that they are the most sacred people and most peace-loving people, while the Congress and the SDPI has all the blame of that. I want to ask all of you that will you ban the Congress party also? And why don't you take the blame on for whole 1 week? You didn't take any action. Now today the police commissioner sahab is exerting and issuing the statement that the police were very swift. But when all these violences started for the whole 1 week, what the police and the investigating agencies and intelligence agencies, what they were doing the whole 1 week? And today you say that it is the SDPI to stop politicizing this, the public sentiments and creating violence and disturbances among the people.
No, but tell me, who are these 19 people, Dr. Rehmani? Dr. Rehmani, who are these 19 people? Are they SDPI? Are they SDPI leaders, workers, members or not? These 19 people, Dr. Tasleem Rehmani, are they not part of SDPI? Were they not present there? Were they not part of this mob? Now, are you trying to say that these 19 did not do any violence, but the other people who were with them resorted to violence? Who's going to believe that? Your guys, your men led this mob.
I said, no, they did not led this mob. They were present over there. I did not deny it at any point of time. They were present over there. There are investigations going on. If they are found guilty, I am the first person to say that they must be punished. If they found, genuinely they found guilty, or anybody else. Anybody else. We in a civilized society, we cannot tolerate any kind of violence from anybody or any political party or the government or whatsoever. So I am very open about it that you cannot blame any outfit just on the basis of their faces and their dresses and attire. As the Prime Minister said, कि हम तो चेहरा देख के और लिप कपड़े देख के पहचान लेते हैं कि मुजरिम कौन है. दिस टेंडेंसी इज द very harmful for the judicial process and for the peace-loving and just-loving people of the country. This fascist mindset cannot run the country. It can ruin the country, which is being happened today. And you see that every time you blame the PFI and SDPI, but you could never substantiate your allegation through the evidence. There is a lot of gap between an incident and an evidence. Always there, hundreds and thousands of our cadre has been arrested, and next 24 hours they have been released because they want to make only a news clip by arresting the SDPI people. They always arrested and made a media headline, and next day they got the bail, and their court cases has been acquitted by the various courts. So how can you blame and corner one democratic and registered political party as a terrorist organization? We know who are the real terrorists in the country. We have seen the people who are involved and proven cases of terrorism, and they are sitting in the parliament. Whose party they belong to? The known terrorist of the country, whose party they belong to.
Okay.
They are because you have given them ticket got them elected and sent them to the parliament, and then you blame the SDPI.
It's it's the same, Dr. Rehmani, then you can't quote that example either, because even in that case, no conviction has happened so far. So it's the same benchmark if it's for you and your party workers who are accused and arrested and repeated violence. Then you can't be questioning Vivek Reddy that. Yes, let me bring in Manu Ayyappa, please. Manu Ayyappa of the Times of India, Senior Editor, Chief of Political Bureau. Thank you so much for being with us, Manu. Is this a pre-planned conspiracy with political links and the clear political agenda, or is it a bunch of people who really just got angry about a Facebook post and resorted to this violence?
Sanvi, I would call this as an electoral riot rather than a religious riot. Simply because if a riot should happen because of some controversial post on Facebook, I think Karnataka should see violence every day. I think hundreds of posts, especially in the coastal belt, you get to see every day a controversial religious post, which should trigger violence, but that's not the case here. It's clearly a turf war among three major political parties, and the BJP, the ruling BJP, is looking to make best use of it. So here the turf war is between the STPI and the Congress on the one end, which is the STPI is desperately looking to gain footing in that Pulkeshwari Nagar constituency and looking forward to win some seats in the upcoming BBMP polls. The Congress, on the other hand, is desperate to retain that its strong bastion and the vote bank. And the BJP is the issue has turned out to be a blessing in disguise for the ruling party, simply because it is usually the BJP does all these kinds of aggravating the religious sentiments. But for a change, the Congress and STPI have done for them, and they are completely enjoying it in a way. But all this has come at the cost of innocent lives and innocent people who just don't understand the politics of it. So the religious sentiments are being used for political gains, as simple as that. So the BJP is looking to make use of
it. Can SDPI, Manu Ayyappa? Yes. The whole fight right now has become about the role of SDPI and now these Congress workers. Now, can SDPI really turn around and say, well, you keep targeting us because we are a Muslim organization and a political outfit and that's just BJP's agenda? How is it that in repeated cases in Karnataka, the name of this outfit is popping up?
In Karnataka, the three major political parties have gained ground. And the STPI, unlike in other states, are struggling to gain footage in this part of the state. So their first attempt is to win local bodies' elections. And they've succeeded in some places, including Dakshin Kala, Kodagu, and some other places. And now they want
to... We have already won. We have won so many seats in local bodies, sir, Mr. Manu. We have won even the BMP seat in the last election. We many village and local village body, urban bodies election, we have won.
That's the danger.
That is not. Yeah, for your information, that is not enough to become a bigger party and win the assembly elections. So it's still poor in your case
that's
to
true.
Take on the BJP and Congress. So now the most important thing is they have to gain foothold in Bangalore, which is the state capital, so that they can easily make inroads to other parts of the state. So this is part of that strategy, and Congress doesn't want the STPI.
What is wrong therein? What is wrong therein? If we are a political party, we shall do it. Is it a wrong policy?
No.
Why it should
not be
every political party tries to make them strong?
He's not making a value judgment.
Clean your history.
Don't come down on the journalist.
No. Playing politics is fine, not on religious lines and not on violence, not killing people. That's my thing.
Yes. Yes, yes, politics, we politics, don't do that. And unfortunately, that's clear. What happens repeatedly in this country. Unfortunately, that's what happens in this country, Dr. Rehmani, to gather hundreds of people and pay for somebody's blood to say, hand over Naveen to us because he wrote a post that offended us. Are you not playing with the religious sentiments of
people? We don't approve. We don't approve those demands. We don't approve.
Using, taking the advantage of their religious sentiments and riling them up over it for your political points?
That an impartial inquiry will tell that, and I don't approve such kind of sloganeering over there that to hand over the culprit to the mob. No, I don't approve, and our party don't approve such kind of an attitude. And I'm still saying that an impartial inquiry must be conducted, and whosoever, even if it is the ruling party, they must have to be booked and punished severely. We don't approve any violence, be it the political, social, or whatever kind, even the cultural. We have seen so many cultural violences, so many political violences, and political killings has become a culture for last 60 days in the country. Thanks to the BJP and RSS politics, we have seen so many of the political stalwarts killed by these political goons, and this culture must have to be discouraged, and we are out to discourage this culture. It's very open, open and clear.
You are not going by your word.
No. Before you start pointing, 1 minute, please. Yes, I am coming to you, Vivek Reddy. But before you point fingers against towards anybody, Dr. Rehmani, you have to look inside your own house. And if people, violent people, antisocial elements, those who pick on religious sentiments and use them for their own advantage, unleash violence, are part of your political outfit, then you have to be responsible for it. You can't just say that that's not my view and that's not what our party does. People in your party are doing it. That's how they're activating your support on the ground. Tomorrow, if you win seats there because you're activating support on the basis of these kind of politics, then how are you going to be any different from those you're pointing fingers at?
I refuse to accept any such allegation of violence. And I'm clean in myself and I'm satisfied. I said it. If it is proof
that Vivek Reddy will respond to you, yes, and then Brijesh Kalapa will come.
Remove them out of the party.
Okay, Mr. Rehmani, please let me just
let us just
assess your conduct. That is what Tanvi was talking about. Also, I want to ask you about your conduct in all the violence cases that have been reported over the past 3 or 4 years or 5 years during the Congress regime or BJP regime. Whichever political structure is there at the state, it is ultimately the pointers and the investigation of the police has gone to you. Whether it is Rudresh case in NIA investigation or whether it is any of these murders, ultimately it has pointed to you. Now, it is very easy for you to come here and give a
big lecture. Yeah, but where is the conviction? That's what he is asking you.
Correct. It is all pending. But what I'm asking is, Tanvi, on the political level, if you are such a sacred cow, you are such a sacred party. Why didn't you eliminate and filter your political party of these violent people, of these goons? Why do you keep them? And after keeping them,
where are the violent people? Where are the violent people? No.
Who gave Pragya Thakur a ticket?
Nothing.
Which party gave Pragya Thakur a ticket?
Nothing is proved.
Pragya.
Nothing is proved against our cadre. Nothing is proved our cadre.
Is a false case.
You give me one incident. You are making us. You are making us a political scapegoat.
She was jailed for 4 years.
Now I can't understand.
No, you are making us a political scapegoat. You are making us a political scapegoat, and we will not.
Okay.
The courts are there.
Okay. 1 minute, please. I think the BJP needs to get one thing straight. If you have evidence. If there is evidence, repeated evidence, if there is evidence, repeated evidence of the SDPI and PFI's involvement in multiple cases, in multiple incidents of violence and large-scale conspiracies, then ban them and get the conviction. Throw them behind bars. I have been hearing this now since your party came to power.
Bring
whether it's in the state of Kerala or it's in the state of Karnataka. State governments, even from north and northeast, are saying the same thing. Where is the action? Why aren't we showing enough evidence for the centre to act on it? Why aren't you taking it up with your home minister and asking him, when are you going to do this? You've been in power for so long. Now,
we have made that recommendation. There is Rajesh Kalappa.
Rajesh Kalappa, if there was an intent. If there is an intent, Rajesh Kalappa, shouldn't it have happened by now? Whether it was your party in power earlier with JDS. 1 minute, please. Vivek Reddy, let me ask Rajesh Kalappa this. Whether it was in your tenure or now in BJP's tenure, we keep hearing about all the links that SDPI has with conspiracy and plots and violent incidents, but no action. Why is that? Who's sheltering them, or is there no evidence?
The first is Tanvi. As far as Vivek is concerned, I think he's a lawyer, so he should know that any ban of any outfit has to be done by the center. And how long has Mr. Modi been the Prime Minister, Tanvi? For 6 years now? For 6 years, we have consistently been hearing of PFI, of SDPI, not just in Karnataka or in Kerala, but we've been hearing it in Jharkhand, in Rajasthan, elsewhere in the country, in Bihar. Everywhere we've been hearing of the role of the PFI.
So why did you remove
you have to understand
cases?
Why the BJP does not want to ban the PFI or the SDPI.
Why did you?
Because they are hand in glove. Because both the BJP cases and the SDPI are the yin and yang of the right wing. So both of them are completely hand in glove. And wherever there is a situation where there is a communal conflagration, it helps either of the two parties. Whenever there is a situation where either the Muslims are angry or the Hindus are angry,
that's why
it's either the SDPI which benefits or the BJP which benefits. So naturally, the BJP will never want to ban the SDPI or the PFI. You will only hear angry talk on television, but you will never find
them actually. This is highly ridiculous situation. This is highly ridiculous situation, Tanvi. This is highly ridiculous statement. Highly ridiculous statement.
What about MIM?
That's why I say that we are the politically scapegoat.
And rolling the BJP, MIM, go and contest elections in Bihar. How does the MIM get money to contest elections in Bihar, Tanvi?
Okay. 1 minute, please. Let Rajesh Kalappa complete, then I'll come to you, Dr. Rahmani.
So I'm saying that as far as the BJP is concerned, they have very deep pockets and they are giving money to the MIM. They are influencing other political parties. So this is how they are managing their entire political structure. So the idea is that let's keep the Congress party out of power. And the only way you can keep the Congress party out of power is by making use of the SDPI, the MIM and so on and so forth. And they're doing it. So they'll never ban these political parties. They are their compatriots. The MIM, SDPI, and the BJP are all coins of the same, the birds of the same feather.
Okay. Tasleem Rehmani wants to respond to what you're saying, Mr. Kalappa. Yes.
No, I would like to interview in, madam. I would like to interview.
That's why I said that these political parties are making us the scapegoat, a political scapegoat. At one at this Congress in 2010, the Home Minister of Congress Party, P. Chidambaramji, and then Shivraj Patil, they keep on labeling us. They have started saying that they are the new avatar of the CB. They blamed us like that. This Congress, because they don't want to see any community leadership to grow. That's why they, at one end, these political part, the Congress, they blame us that the BJP, we are becoming a BJP, B team, and the BJP tried to iconize us, create a binary of hate at the name of SDPI polarize the voters on the communal line. The BJP is using this card and the Congress is using that card, while the Congress itself has become a soft Hindutva political party for so long. They lost the Assam election because of their soft Hindutva. They lost the Karnataka election and their MLAs has changed, shifted the poll to the BJP because of their soft Hindutva plan. That's why they are losing their ground and they are blaming us. They are blaming us. You see yourself. Look at you. What you are doing at the name of secularism in the country. And look at the BJP, what they are doing at the name of Hindutva in the country. Both these political parties, the general voter has become fed up of these politics, has become fed up of these
politics. Unfortunately,
the whole society has been polarized.
And Vivek Reddy, Rajesh Kalappa, to everybody, secularism, let's not even use that term frivolously anymore. Nobody follows it. Nobody believes in it. Not in politics, at least. Now, two panelists I need to
what go to.
Mr. Prasad Gowda wanted to make a point, and then to Manu Ayyappa. Yes, Prasad Gowda first.
That's why we
use Prasad Gowda. Madam, politics.
Madam, one thing I would like to mention.
In,
at this
we're
point
not going
of
to
juncture,
get justice. What about law and order?
Yeah. At this point of juncture, I would like to make one observation. Bangalore never witnessed this kind of violence so far. This is the we have seen the biggest violence which has happened that I can say now. We are seeing on the television sets youths are destroying the public properties. But we need to, police department really have to identify who is the mastermind behind all this whole show. It is, if required, I demand CBI Pro to identify the mastermind behind all these things. Because Bangalore
CBI Pro.
It is very unfortunate. I'm using this word. Bangalore was...
love that everybody now, has to has demand for CBI violent, probe? And why CBI probe?
No, let police investigate. If they fail, let them give it to CBI. We have no issue. But we need to understand. And
that's what will happen then,
Mr.
Prasad Gowda. First police will investigate, then CBI will come, then maybe we'll call the ED also,
yes.
Then the NIA will also follow up, new theories will come up, the cases will just keep going on, investigation will just keep going on for years together, keep milking it, keep getting your political brownie points, every party will use it for their own election. Next week we cycle of elections, from local body elections to the state elections, will just continue like this.
They have to do it very immediately.
There is absolutely no interest that any government shows in delivering justice, giving us the facts of a case. Everything, unfortunately, becomes political and communal in this country. And that's what has happened to the Bengaluru incident as well. Very quickly, Mr. Manu Ayyappa, are we forgetting the core focus in this investigation? The police commissioner also said that the police is stretched, they're understaffed, half of them are quarantined or COVID positive. They had to call in for backup from other localities and other stations because they didn't have enough people. Is there a larger concern that we're not looking at?
Yeah, certainly, Tanvi. See, the rhetoric of banning STPI won't work because it's a political party. If you have to ban a political party, then all parties have to be banned, including Congress and BJP, for religious reasons or aggravating religious sentiments. So STPI banning is ruled out. But then the BJP will continue to play that political thing that they will recommend to the center to ban STPI. That will go on. Since last, I think, 3 recommendations have gone to the center, but no decision has been taken on banning STPI simply because it works in their favor. The reason is that STPI is largely a threat to the Congress and JDS rather than BJP. One. Second, this kind of communal acts always polarizes voters and it works into the advantage of the BJP. Third, the investigation by a district magistrate is just another exercise. It won't work. And you can't hand over a violence to a CBI, because if that is the case, in hundreds of violence happen across the country, and CBI can't be working on violence after violence. So it's all rhetoric by the political parties that you hand over to the CBI, you hand over to the SIT or something else. But finally, if you go back to that Mangalore violence thing, ultimately the district magistrate conducted the investigation and nothing happened. So it's the same thing will happen to this case also. Only thing we have to regret is 3 innocents of lives have been lost, hundreds have been injured, public properties have been damaged at the cost of a petty politics. That's it.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think this is a point that the viewers need to understand. This is a point that people in this country need to begin to understand. It's gone on for far too long. Politicians repeatedly pick on your insecurities. Politicians repeatedly push an idea in your head and then pick on your sentiments. religious or otherwise, and use it for their own benefit. Nobody cares that over 70 policemen got injured. They don't care that 3 people have been killed. What they care is the narrative that gets built out of such incidents. Is a narrative about which man put up what post hurting whose religious sentiments, whether that man is connected to the Congress party or connected to the BJP, relative of a Congress party person but ideology of a BJP. That's all the conversation that the politicians want to have, instead of actually looking into what went wrong on ground. How can we protect our people? That should be the focus. In times of a pandemic, if a mob of 800 people can run amok in one of our biggest metro cities in this country, there is something terribly going wrong, either with the law and order capabilities of that police force, or this was a conspiracy with a decent amount of political support. Think about it, viewers. Let us stop falling prey for these divisive tactics that are repeatedly used for vote bank politics. Thank you for joining us on this conversation.